My name is Clara Mshanga Mwansa. I'm from Fountain School. Today we are going to look at CTS. And in CTS, we are going to look at food. So, food, we'll look at the preservation of food. So, what is food? What is food? Food is anything that we eat and drink and gives us the nutrition. So food is anything that we eat, drink and gives us the nutrition. So we are looking mostly at the preservation of food. Preserving food, preservation of food is actually a method how we keep our food. So food is, food preservation is a method in which we keep our food. So by keeping our food, there are some methods that we use. So let me just write food preservation for you. So, we've seen here, food is the preservation of food is preservation is the method of keeping food for future use. So this food, usually we keep it so that we should use it for another time. There are some food that we keep, like drying food. That's one method of keeping food, I mean. So, like drying, if we get, for example, we get beans. Beans, you can dry it. We remove the moisture, we keep it dry. And you can use it, like this time, it's June. You can use it in December for a future, we keep them for a future use. So, preservation is simply keeping food for future use. So drying is one method of keeping food for future use. We can also freeze. Let's say chicken. Chicken, you can freeze it. You put it in a freezer where it is iced. So when it's iced, it can be kept for some time without getting it rotten. We can also can. By canning, you put, for example, let's say fish. Fish, you can put it in a can for a long time. We've seen fish, we can export. Like fish, you can import it from China, it will come here in Zambia, people use it and it won't get bad. That is it, canning. Then we've got, I've mentioned dried, freezing and canning. So these are some of the methods that we can use for freezing. So which other method can we use apart from canning, freezing and the drying? Okay, smoking. Smoking is also used for preserving food. So canning we can also, I mean smoking we can use it also for preserving, even salting. Salting, we can also salt fish. Let's say fish, you put it in a salt solution and you keep it out there to dry. That one is also another method of preserving food. So we've got methods of preserving food. then the importance, we've got the importance of keeping food. The importance of keeping food is one, they should not go bad. They should not go bad. Who can tell us another method for preserving food? The importance of preserving food. Who can tell us another importance of preserving food? Okay? Another importance of for preserving food is it should not have bacteria, meaning it should not get spoiled. So another method is not wasting by throwing away food, because if you don't preserve it, you don't dry it, you can the food can go bad. So by not wasting, by not having them have bacteria. And the other thing is to keep them long. To keep them long. So by keeping them long, you can use it for a future use. So preserving food is very important in our life, because that also helps us to keep our food. Let me just write the some methods that are used for preserving. The method we say D, smoking, freezing, drying. Methods, say smoking, freezing, drying, and canning. So these are some of the methods that are used for preserving food. So I said the importance we said to keep them prevent from bacteria. Okay. So these are some of the importance of preventing food. So to keep the food from moving for a long time. So this you are able to keep the food for a long time. You prevent the food from bacteria and reduce the wasting. Because if we don't prevent this food, definitely we waste the food by throwing them away because they have bacteria. So the importance is it by drying them, smoking, freezing, and canning. Oh, I also left out salting. Salting is also one way of preservation. So these are the methods. So if we keep our, if we freeze, smoke, dry, can or salt this food, then they won't go to waste. We'll keep them for a long time and we'll be able to use them for another time. So we'll go into an activity where I will ask you to write an exercise on food preservation. So in food preservation, I mentioned that food preservation is the method of keeping food for a long time. So we said food preservation is the way of keeping our food for a long time. I also mentioned the methods. The methods of who preserving food. I said smoking is one of them. Freezing is one of them. Drying, canning, and salting. I also mentioned the importance of preserving food. So I said to keep the food for a long time. I also mentioned preventing the food from bacteria. I also mentioned to reduce the wasting. So we are going to write an activity on food preservation. So these are the questions that we are going to write. The first one is, what is preservation? What is preservation? The second one, mention three methods of preserving food. Mention three methods of preserving food. Number three. State one importance of food preservation. Mention one importance of food preservation. Okay, thank you for writing this exercise. I think we are all done. This is what we learned about. We talked about it, food preservation. I think we all will be able to know more about this, and we'll be able to explain to our friends about food preservation. My name is Clara Mianga Mwansa from Fountain School. Thank you very much.